the crew trying to turn it on in the last couple of rounds, obviously. The scheduled for 8 then at welterweight, just to remind you, 10 stone 9, they both weigh. 10-7 is the welterweight division. Big tank keeps rolling on, all right. Seven wins for True. He's only actually stopped 9, but as you say, Jimmy, he normally does pressure fight as he wins the wars of attrition. It's going to take some stopping, however, he's yet to hit the deck at all. He's hooking, he's been giving it all, these two. How good a reverse there by the crew, with probably the tucking up the elbows close to the body there, trying to block the punches. This really is a typical True war and a typical Somerville war. They couldn't have been better match, really. And this is a flash. We saw a few signs in the other part of the round that the True is maybe going to take over a little bit. And then just as we felt that was happening, Somerville comes blazing back again. This really is a crash up. Still bloodied around the nose and the storm set it all, but it's not really giving Somerville any trouble. He was just not firing back at that point, Somerville. Following that good work in the fifth round, the crew stepped it up in the sixth, and Somerville simply ran out of gas, but at no time did he run out of heart.
So long to get another shot at the British title, having lost it. I mean, you don't lose many fights. Where does that leave you now?
Well, it's just climbing the big ladder again, you know. It's just right back to square one, really. You know, you can't just say die. No fighter says die, and he just comes back from it.
But it is a blow to you.
It's definitely a blow, you know. He knocks me back quite a few rungs on the ladders, you know, but I'll climb back up. There's no fear of that.
To be called what they got on the poster now, KO Stas Petru, and that was lived up to it tonight.
He certainly did. Congratulations.
Cheers.
Well
done. He's always been confident, Stas Petru, but you can almost see it now, Jim. It's absolutely surging now, doesn't it? Here he is. He's well on top again in this round, Thompson. Oh, three on the turn left, Thompson. He looked as though he was going, but Wolf managed to pull himself together. But I'm wondering if he can hold out now in this round. About a minute left. True sense that he's willing to spin his gum shield out. He's got it hanging out of his mouth, but he's battling away there, Foster's Petru. And Bacon's going to dive in the ninth round. And the Greek tank from Birmingham really switched it on when it mattered.
more suspect to say, could he stop the through? I mean, he's such a tough guy, but there was a moment or two there when the referee looked as though he just might start diving in, but he's back again for through. Incredible.
See, this is what Petrou breaks people's hearts when they connect with a manager, punches and Petrou comes storming back at him. He's done this so often.
Seventh round of a really tough welterweight battle, this. Right from the start, Jim Watanabe said, well, our favourite must be, I think not only is it living up to expectations, it's the passer.
Think that until I come back, and then I surprise them all. They just think, where's this guy coming from? And here I am, there as you see, I'm still hitting him. I'm not easing off, I'm just keep on hitting him. And it's the referee that's got to pull me off in the air.
It's an interesting situation because you've got to wait now while they have the eliminator for the British title between Rocky Kelly and the unbeaten George Collins.
I don't care, let them fight, let them sort it out. I'm there, I'm waiting, I don't care who I take, I'll fight anybody, I'm not bothered. Sylvester Mitty's amongst there and he's come to watch me, so Sylvester Mitty knows who's going to be the next British champion, otherwise he wouldn't have bothered to come here. So I'm going to show him and I'll be ready for him anyway.